I'm Peggy Duncan with SweetMinute.com. When I need photos for my presentations, I'll either take my own or I'll grab something that's free on the Microsoft Images website. I prefer photos, and when I can't find exactly what I need, I'll alter. I recently needed someone in bed working on a laptop. I found a picture of just a bed and another of a woman sitting outside on the grass. So I removed the background in her photo and I merged the two. Here's how I did it. I'm in PowerPoint 2010 and I've inserted both the pictures on the slide. So the first thing I'll do is crop what I don't want out of this picture. I double click the picture, the format tab shows up, and I'll crop and take out what I don't need, get as close to her as I can. Okay, I'll click off of that. Now I need to remove the background. Zoom in and blow up my screen a little bit. It's not a high-res photo, so it's a little fuzzy, but it's okay for what I need. And double-click the photo, format tab shows up, remove background. And I'm going to, all of the fuchsia is going to disappear. Pull out here. Feet. Let me reduce the screen some. I want to make sure I get all of her feet. And okay, let me keep the changes. And I'm going to go back in there and mark areas that I want to keep. And with this little pencil, I'm trying to get a little bit more of her shirt. And it's giving me some of that background that I don't want. I'm going to undo that, both of those, and try again. Get it a little bit closer to the shirt. No, but in this particular case, I can actually, that's pretty good. That's for what I need, that will work. It is tedious sometimes. You might have to go in and play with it a lot, but I think for now, this is going to be okay. I'm going to keep changes or even just click off of it. And I do want to get rid of whatever that is. It's a piece of the wall. So I'll go back in there, mark areas to remove, and I'll draw the line right there. Try to get rid of that. Got rid of too much. Let me go back to keep and see if I can keep that part of her shirt. Okay, that's great. That's good enough for what I need. And sometimes I will take the photo, double click. I'm going to add an effect to soften the edges a little bit so it won't look so raggedy. Might need to do that a little more. And sometimes it'll take out too much of the photo, so that won't work. But I think I'll just leave it at 2.5. Okay, so now I'm going to reduce her down and just drag her over to the bed and try to get your perspective right. I'm not a photographer, but that looks about right. I could put her up like this over the bed, but just play with it until you think the angles are about right. And that might be okay. After I'm done, I'm going to take my mouse and draw around all of these two images. Now both of them are selected, and I will arrange and group as one image. And there you go. If you like this video, give me a thumbs up and click to share it with your social network. Subscribe to my channel while you're here and be among the first to know when I post a new video. I'm Peggy Duncan, sweetminute.com.